Rise and shine, spawn of Lilith, rise and shine. Ah, you're awake. How was your nap?
What is this place? Where have you taken me?
You are in the vicinity of the Rat Kingdom. More specifically, my dungeon.
The Rat Kingdom? Is that what you call it?
Well, to be honest, this planet wasn't called the Rat Kingdom before. This planet was once home to the race known as the Chungai, that is, until I liberated it, and killed those wretched creatures who got in my way.
The Chungai? You mean this was...
Yes. This was Big Chungus's home.
Then why does he work for you?
He's not. At least not of his own free will. When I captured him, I implanted a V-chip in his brain, so that he would obey my every command. It was for the greater good of my people.
You committed a genocide.
Those are strong words coming from someone who turned every living thing into goop, spawn of Lilith.
My name is Rey.
Yes, I know. Your name is Rey. Or, would it be better if I called you, Yui Ikari?
How do you know that?
I know more about you than you might think. Here, let me tell you something. When I became ruler of the Rat Kingdom, I promised my people that if they were loyal to me, I would give them what you would call the American Dream. They were so loyal, in fact, that I would make them work in rock mines and sweatshops, all while they were making the bare minimum. You may call that wage slavery, but I like to call it capitalism. Sounds more friendlier. Then one day, the criminal known as Spaceman Stan came, and turned my men against me. Fortunately, I ran the spaceman out of my planet, and executed those who betrayed me. Then one day, while I was traveling through space, I came across something rather mesmerizing. I witnessed a giant lady rising from the Earth's atmosphere, turning the entire planet red. This catastrophe was known as the Third Impact. I landed on this now deserted planet, and came across a few papers entitled, The Human Instrumentality Project. When I came back, I told my men the tale of the spawn of Lilith, and if they captured her, then their American dream would finally come true. What they don't know, is that I will use your power to further rule over the galaxy, maybe even the universe. No more messing with Mr. Small Fry anymore. So, what do you think of my plan?
You're crazy. You have no idea the kind of damage that will do.
Oh, I've planned this very carefully. I've even created my very own Lilith for this occasion.
Oh my god.
All I need now is the location of the Eva unit.
He doesn't know where it is. It was right under his nose. I'll never tell you, and I'll never work for you.
Funny, that's what Chungus told me as well. Good thing I planted a chip in you just in case. Now, you will tell me the location of the Eva unit.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Hold on, what's that noise?
Rey, are you okay?
What the? Doge, is that you?
Oh, thank God you're alive. Hurry, we gotta get you on the ship before anyone else shows up.
Hey, buddy, I'm speaking in an accent that is beyond her range of hearing.
Damn it, Wheatley. Now's not the time.
Run, I don't need to do the voice. Run, run!
How the hell did they survive? No matter, Chungus, get them.
He's gaining on us. Zeems, we gotta move faster.
Siri, activate light beam.
I think we lost them. Did he hurt you?
No, but he did put a chip into my brain.
A chip? Is it still in you? Gross.
Wait a minute, why is he on board?
Oh, you mean Thomas? Yeah, about that. Apparently he wants to help us now.
And you believe him?
Not really, but he's managed to help us out so far.
It's true. Stuart left me to die. And if it wasn't for your penguin friend, I wouldn't be here today. So I've decided that I'm gonna be on the right side of history.
Whatever you say, Tommy. Listen, I need you to wait in the kitchen. I gotta start the news show. I'll try to get this done as quick as I can.
All right.
Hello, I'm Doge, and welcome to another edition of Doge News, where we bring you the latest scoop on movies, games, and world events. Let's start off with some breaking news. Joseph Robinette Biden Jr., former Vice President to Barack Obama, will now become the 46th President of the United States, carrying 306 electoral votes out of the 270 votes needed to win. This also makes Senator Kamala Harris the first woman to be Vice President, as well as the first African American and Asian American to be Vice President. President Donald Trump has refused to concede the election, citing false claims of voter fraud, but ultimately, President-elect Biden and Vice President-elect Harris will be sworn in on January 20, 2021. Here's good luck to Biden and Harris's first 4 years in the White House. In other news, the famous Armenian-American metal band, System of a Down, has recently released two new singles for the first time in 15 years to raise awareness of the conflict between Azerbaijan and Artsakh, which ultimately ended in a ceasefire, with Azerbaijan declaring victory. The band has spent the last 25 years raising awareness to the 1915 Armenian genocide that was perpetrated by the Turkish government, which has refused to acknowledge their part in the Armenian genocide for 105 years. If you would like to help Armenia, you can donate to the Armenian Fund with the link in the description. One last bit of news for today. FCC Chairman Ajit Pai, most known as the man who repealed net neutrality, has announced that he will be stepping down as FCC chairman on January 20, the same day that President-elect Biden is expected to be sworn in the White House. This has caused speculation on whether or not Biden will reinstate net neutrality laws once he's sworn in, though it is expected that Biden will pick the new chairman of the FCC once he takes office. Well, that's all the time we have. Holy shit.
Space.
Ah! Space bombs.
Did you really think that you would escape from me that easily? You're not the only one who can travel through light speed.
You! You left me to die. After all I've done for you.
Ah, I see you've gotten help from the traitor. Don't worry, your head will be served on a platter for your treasonous sacrilege.
Damn it, Stuart. Leave us alone. You're not getting Ray back, and we're running the hell away from you where you can't find us.
Leaving so soon? You've just arrived. You haven't even seen the surprise gift I planned for you. Chungus, show him. Oh look, it's your old man. Spaceman Stan, Earth's greatest rock collector. At least that's what it says in the engravings.
What? How did you-
I told Chungus to take your father's urn when he captured Ray. I'm surprised you've now figured that out, but it doesn't matter anymore. It's time I finally have my revenge.
Wait, what are you doing?
Something I should have done a long time ago.
No, don't do it.
Spaceman Stan, you are being charged for your attempted coup against my kingdom. And for that, I sentence you to death.
I swear to God if you touch him.
Whenever you are ready, Chungus.
Please think about this. No. You son of a bitch. I'll fucking kill you.
Doge.
Doge, where are you going? Don't press it.
Do not press that button!
Stomp.
Get off of me. Let me kill the bastard.
Ray, I need you to get us out of here now. Doge, you need to calm down.
Calm down? I'll show you who to fucking calm down.
Space!
Space balls.
Space!
Get us out of here now.
Exile. It takes your mind again. Exile.
Your Majesty, I think we've lost contact with the perpetrators.
Nonsense. I know they're hiding in these asteroids somewhere. Start looking.
Have they found us yet?
No, not yet.
Good God, what do we do?
We stay quiet as we can. And not try to give away our location.
Don't worry, Pinpin. It's gonna be okay. At least I hope it is.
Well, you see, about the staying quiet part. I gotta start the news show.
Are you kidding me?
Look, I know it's the wrong time, but right now is the scheduled time for me to do this. It's something for me to record so I can look back on when I come back home. At least, that was supposed to be the plan. I guess there's no point in me doing this now.
Fine, but make it quick. The camouflage mode can only last for a few minutes. And don't play any kind of music either.
Hello, I'm Doge, and welcome to another edition of Doge News, where we bring you the latest scoop on movies, games, and world events. Let's start off with some breaking news. Cyberpunk 2077, the most highly anticipated game of 2020, has been delisted off of the PlayStation Store and is offering refunds due to the game's poor launch. The game at launch suffered from countless bugs, glitches, crashes, and some promises from the devs that weren't kept in the final game. CD Projekt, the publisher behind Cyberpunk, is being lambasted for the game's poor launch and its reliance on 80-hour employee work weeks. The publisher is also facing four different class action lawsuits due to the publisher lying about the state of the game to shareholders. What an incredible disappointment from a once respected company. In other news, the 2020 Game Awards has wrapped up, and here are the results. The Last of Us Part 2 won 7 awards, including Game of the Year. Other nominees such as Final Fantasy VII Remake and Ghost of Tsushima won 2 awards that night, with Doom Eternal ending up receiving no awards in the ceremony. Some game announcements included the reveal of Sephiroth as the next Smash Fighter, a new Perfect Dark game from The Initiative, a new Mass Effect game, and Back 4 Blood, a spiritual successor to Valve's Left 4 Dead games. Congratulations to both the winners and nominees. One last bit of news.
Where are you, Doge? You can't hide from me forever.
Doge, ramp it up quick.
One last bit of news for today. Adobe Flash, the computer software for web browsers, was officially discontinued on December 31st of 2020. Adobe Flash was best known for its creation of animations and games such as Salad Fingers, Super Smash Flash 2, Metal Gear Awesome, and countless other projects. Adobe Flash will forever be missed by the online animation community.
Your Majesty, we've looked everywhere for them, but we've found no trace. Should we call off the hunt?
No. He's trying to make a fool out of me, and if he thinks he can do that, then he's sorely mistaken. I want you to blast every single one of these asteroids to smithereens.
Are you sure about
that's
this?
That's an order.
Your Majesty, there are only two asteroids left.
I want all of our firepower on one of those asteroids.
But Your Majesty...
Now.
So this is how we die.
No, I'm too young.
Shinji, I'm sorry.
We are doomed.
The end.
Doge, I know you're in there. You're lucky that you picked a good hiding spot, but your luck will eventually run out. I can't kill you yet, but I can make your life a living hell. I know where your home planet is now, and if you don't bring Rey to me, I will annihilate your planet, and every pathetic being living there. Then I will make your name the most vilified, to the point where you'll never find a safe spot in the galaxy. So, I'll give you one last chance, bring her to me. Show yourself, you low-life mutt. A coward, just like your father. So be it then. I will make it my life's mission for you to suffer. You will regret this decision.
Siri, deactivate camouflage mode.
So what now?
We run away.
Wait, what? Doge, what are you talking about?
I have a plan. We travel far away to a hospitable planet and live there for the rest of our lives. A planet so far away that Stuart can never find us. We can all build a cottage and start a farm life.
So that's your plan? Just give up?
It's better than nothing.
So you're just gonna let him call you a coward and let him blow up your home?
Yes. Yes, I am, because maybe he's right. Maybe I am a coward. You saw what he's capable of. We can't hold a candle to him. We might as well give up.
Doge, do you remember what Shinji said? I mustn't run
Look,
away.
I don't know who you take me for, but I'm not Shinji, and I never will be. Maybe he could take him on, but he's gone now.
Even so, are you just gonna let Stuart treat his people like slaves?
You mean those rats? Those fuckers tried to kill us. Like I give a damn about what they want.
Those people are my friends you're talking about, you dirty mutt.
Don't you fucking ever call me a mutt again.
What about Spaceballs? Didn't you at least care about him?
Spaceballs? What about him? He's the one who got clumsy and got into that chute. If he wasn't such a stupid klutz, he wouldn't have died. You've been a thorn in my ass for far too long.
You have been a thorn in my side long enough.
We should have left you where you belong, you metal brain moron.
I am not a moron!
Stop this now.
Well, how about now? Now who's a moron?
Get this fucker off my ship. Let him be someone else's problem.
You need to calm down.
No. I'm through with being calm. If you didn't tackle me to the ground, I would have killed that fucker then and there.
You would have gotten us all killed if you did that. You knew that it was dangerous to press the button, but you let your emotions get the best of you.
That's enough. I'm the captain of this goddamn ship, and I make the rules. We're flying far away from this galaxy and that's final. Now shut your fucking mouths up.
I can believe it.
Hey, where are you going? Come on, don't be like that. Zeems, you still have my back, right?
He had my brother at gunpoint. Aren't you pissed about that? You know what, forget I asked. I already know the answer.
Fine. I don't need you, I don't need anyone. I can do this all on my own. God damn it, this is all your fault. Dad? Is that you?
Hello there, son. It's been a while, hasn't it?
I can't believe it. Is this real?
It's as real as it's gonna get. So tell me, what's been troubling you?
I failed. I failed you, Dad. Stuart took your urn and smashed it into pieces. I tried to kill him. But I failed at that too. Now there's no point in me moving forward anymore.
Hey now, there's no need to say that. You still have a mission to do, right?
What mission? There's nothing left for me to do.
Of course there is. You still have a mission to stop Stuart from destroying our home.
And how do you expect me to do that? He wants me dead. And has an entire army at his disposal to do so. Might as well run away like you did.
Doge, I understand that it's much easier for you to give up, but you still have friends who depend on you.
You mean the same friends who turned their backs on me when I gave them the option of living a new life?
Doge, please listen, you can't just give up now, not when there's so much on the line. They need you. Ray needs you.
I can't be who she wants me to be. I can't be Shenji, and I can't be you. I'm just a fool who tried to fulfill a dead man's errand.
I get it, Doge. You still hate me.
God damn it, Dad. I don't hate you, even though I probably should. I did all this because I still care about you. I put my whole life in peril because I still love you. And maybe if I did hate you, I wouldn't have agreed on this suicide mission. Maybe I could have gone to college and have a career by now. Maybe even start a family. Lord knows you never cared. I just wish you were there for me.
You know, Doge, you kinda remind me of someone I knew. You just don't realize it yet.
What are you talking about? Wait a minute, that was never there. What's going on?
Doge, you mustn't run away.
What is this?
You mustn't run away. You mustn't run away. You mustn't run away. You mustn't run away.
No, you must leave me alone. Get out of my head.
You mustn't run away. You mustn't run away. You mustn't run away. You mustn't run away.
Jesus, I must have had a nightmare. Maybe I should go take a shower. What the hell is happening to me? You know, it's been pretty quiet lately. A little too quiet. Well, hello there, Zeems. How are you doing?
Fine.
Nice weather outside, don't you think?
Don't you have some show to do?
Oh, yeah, I guess I do. Hello, I'm Doge, and welcome to another edition of Doge News, where we bring you the latest scoop on movies, games, and world events. Let's start off with some breaking news. Colonial Pipeline, the operator of the biggest gasoline pipeline in the United States, was hacked by a ransomware group named DarkSod, which led to the pipeline shutting down. This resulted in the uptick in gas prices, as well as panic buying from customers, who resorted to filling up gasoline in plastic grocery bags. Colonial Pipeline has agreed to pay the ransom of $4.4 million to the hacking group. The hacking group defended itself by saying that it didn't mean to create problems, though President Joe Biden has suggested that he'll bring the hacking group to justice. In other news, a 12-story condo in Surfside, Florida collapsed on itself, with one reported to be dead, and 99 other people unaccounted for. Let's all hope that the people who are stuck in the condo are found and safe. One last bit of news for today. Kentaro Miura, most known for being the author of the genre-defining manga Berserk, passed away at the age of 54 due to an acute aortic dissection. Miura was praised for his talented and detailed art style, and has been an influence to many other artists who read his work, that of which being Berserk, an epic dark fantasy tale that has spanned for more than 30 years. However, with Miura's passing, the story of Berserk has now been left unfinished, with many in the community debating whether or not to have the story be continued, or be left alone. Miura has left behind a great and influential legacy, and will be forever missed by his fans and family. Well, that's all the time. What the hell? The ship stopped. Zeems, the ship just stopped.
Yems, I know.
Are you gonna fix it?
Sorry, but I don't really feel like it.
What? Zeems, you fix this ship right now.
I'm in the mood.
Damn it, Zeems, I'm the captain of this ship, and I command
not
you-
not anymore.
What?
While you were filming your news show, we all grouped together and formed a union, and we all voted for a new captain.
Wheatley, what the hell are you doing up there?
You know what you are? Selfish. All you've done is boss me around. Well, now who's the boss? Who's the boss? It's me.
Damn it, Wheatley. I swear to fucking God.
Doge. We need to talk.
Ray, what's the meaning of this?
Please listen, Doge. We have to stop Stuart from conquering the galaxy and destroying your planet. I thought I could have convinced you last night, but I guess I was mistaken.
So that wasn't just a dream I had. That's why I saw him in the mirror. Why the hell would you do that to me? How much did you tell everyone?
I told them everything I knew. Look, you can be mad at me all you want, but right now we need to do the right thing. Your father tried to save the rats from their exploitation. The least we can do is help them.
Oh, please. Like my father really cared. He probably only did it so he could feel like a hero. All that bastard did was collect a bunch of useless space rocks. To hell with him, and to hell with it all.
You and I both know that's not true.
I don't care how many times you try to convince me, you're not going to change my mind.
No. I can't. But maybe this will. I found this picture frame in your room.
Give me that. First you get into my head, and next you're stealing from my room. How is this supposed to convince me?
Look at the back. There's something hidden in there.
A flash drive?
There's something in that flash drive that you may want to see.
How can I be sure that it's not one of your magic tricks?
I assure you that it's not.
And you expect me to believe—
Just plug the damn thing in.
Hello? Is this thing on? Captain's log. Stardate, June 24th, 2010.
Ugh, he was always such a nerd.
Today is my son's 9th birthday. I promised him that we would play a game of baseball, but I had other plans. You know, I don't like lying to my son. I don't like leaving him and my wife alone. I wish I could take them along with me, but if something happened to them, I just don't know how I would live with myself. All this time of me spending in space, I could be spending time with my family, but ever since that recession happened, money's been pretty tight. This is the only viable way I can support my family, other than maybe slaving away my time in some cubicle, and I'll be damned if I ever do that again.
Dad?
I didn't even have time to give him a present. But luckily, me and stuff made something special for him. It's a teddy bear I stitched together, and stuff helped me stuff it up as well. No pun intended. I even put in a little recorder inside, so that when he presses it, he can always hear my voice while I'm gone. Not a day goes by that I don't think about him. I just hope that Doge understands why I'm doing this when he's older, though I can't really blame him if he ends up hating me. Maybe I deserve it.
Stan, you done with that camera? I want you to see this.
Almost. Doge. If you ever do come across this video, just remember that I'm always thinking about you, and that I'll always love you. Never forget that.
Doge, I believe this is for you.
I love you.
Listen, everyone, I'm sorry. I acted like a jerk to you all. I was angry and brash, and said things I didn't mean, especially to Spaceballs. I'm afraid. Afraid that I can't stop Stuart, that I'm not strong enough to take him on. A captain should never be afraid, and I failed you all. You deserve a better captain than me.
We're all afraid, Doge. But we can't let our fear consume us. I've lost count on how many times I've died, and all the times I was brought back. I still felt fear. But I still kept going. Stuart has given us all pain, and it's time that we give Stuart the pain that he's given us, but not without you. Not without all of us.
But we'll die.
Then let our deaths not be in vain. When we confront him, we'll hit him where it really hurts.
Yems. Let's do this.
Count me in.
Right, let's go! What's the worst that could happen?
Ah, what the hell? Why not? Let's teach that bastard a lesson.
Ah!
Huh. I thought that would stink on a bit longer.
So, do you have anything in mind?
Yes, I have.
Dad, please don't do this.
I'm sorry, Rusty, but I have no choice.
You don't have to shut down the shop. Please listen.
No, Rusty. You listen to me. That rat stole our inventory, almost had you killed, and now I've sent Zeems and his friends to die.
Dad, none of that was your fault.
Oh, who am I kidding? I couldn't save your mom, and now I've sent your brother to his death. I'm a horrible father. I don't even deserve to wear this hat.
No.
I believe you dreamt this.
Zeems, you're alive. What happened? Wait a minute. Why is that rat here?
It's a long story. Look, Stuart is about to destroy my planet, and we don't have much time.
We need to know if you still have the EVA unit.
That robot thing? Yeah, it's the only thing they didn't take, but it's not gonna do much if it does, eh? Where are you running off to?
Please stay back.
What in the Sam hell are you doing?
I don't know. But I'm hoping it works.
What the hell just happened? Where'd Ray go?
Up here.
No way. Ray, are you in that?
Yes. Yes, I am.
Whoa. That's so cool.
Took the words out of my mouth, kid.
Zeems, ready the ship and tow the EVA unit up. Murphy, I promise that we'll get your stuff back.
Wait. We're going as well. We want to help you take down that rat bastard.
Yeah.
Very well then. We head for the Rat Kingdom. Let's end this once and for all.
Ah yes, you're all ready. You all know what your objective is. We travel to the Mutt's home planet, and nuke it all to kingdom come. Make him wish that he'd never turned down my offer. Enough wasting time, we're getting on board now.
Your Majesty, can I ask you something?
It better be quick.
Before we go, can I at least tell my family goodbye? I haven't seen them since the spawn of Lilith escaped.
Yeah, I haven't seen my wife for days. She's probably worried about me.
I haven't eaten anything in a while too.
We haven't had a break in a while. We're tired and hungry. Can't we schedule this for another day?
A break? A fucking break? We're so close to greatness and now you want a break?
But Your Majesty—
Don't you but me, soldier, or I'll have you on Chungus's dinner.
Yes, Your Majesty. I apologize, Your Majesty.
That goes for you all as well. I am the king, and I will not be treated like a worthless peasant like all of you, so no more stupid questions. Now let's go.
Your Majesty.
Damn it, what did I just say?
Look over there.
Well, I'll be. Doge. Quite the nerve to show your face here. Where's the girl?
Who? Ray? She left. She and the rest of the crew took my ship and abandoned me here. Some kind of friends they were.
Is that so? Well, if you're here to beg for mercy, then you're very mistaken.
I'm not here for your mercy. I lost everything, Stuart. Got nothing left. Feel the best thing I should do is end it all. And leave forever.
What are you implying?
Are you dense? I want your man to kill me. I already told you I got nothing left. At that point, why even live?
Ah. Too much of a coward to do it yourself. Or maybe this is your poor attempt at martyrdom. I gave you a chance for you and your planet to live, and you spat in my face. Your death will be as meaningless as the putrid souls on your planet that I will destroy. But look on the bright side. You and your family can suffer together in hell.
Sure. Whatever. Just make it quick.
On my command. Ready. Aim. Fire. That's enough. What?
Huh. Your man must have missed me. Maybe aim for the face next time.
What? How did you... shoot the bastard?
Looks like I'm bulletproof. Guess since I'm here, I might as well tell you about your so-called illustrious majesty. Has Stuart ever told you about the real reason why he wants my friend to himself? I bet he hasn't. He wants to make clones of Rey to take over the galaxy, and impose his rule on the planets that reside there.
What? But King Stuart, I thought you promised us the American dream.
And I will. He's just lying to you all. He's pulling tricks on us.
Silly Stuart, tricks are for kids. Ain't that right, Big Chungus? Oh, speaking of which, did you ever tell them that you killed his people, and enslaved him to your dirty work?
Lies. All lies.
You said it yourself, Stuart, right to her face.
I've had enough of these tricks. I will find her, you dirty mutt. Impossible.
You want her? Come and get her.
Hello! This is the part where I kill you! You know we're under attack! Wait up!
Chungus, enlarge.
What happened? Damn it, I can't move. Zeems, where are you?
Down here. I can't move.
Get me out of this thing.
Murphy, can you hear me? Murphy? Rusty? Wheatley?
Oh, how sad. Crushed by your own ambitions. And what a valiant effort, too. It almost makes me feel pity. This game of yours is over, and I've won, and the only prize you'll be getting is your death. On my command. Ready. Aim.
Wait. Before you kill me, can you at least give me one last thing to say?
Ugh, fine, but make it snappy.
Your men. Do they respect you?
What kind of question is that? Of course they respect me. I'm their king after all. Now then. On with your execution.
I'm not done. Do they respect you out of admiration, or out of fear?
Out of fear? How dare you say that?
Tell me, Stuart, how long have you been leading your people into this facade that the American dream will come true? How many of your people did you coax into doing back-breaking labor under a false pretense? I wonder, if you do take Raid, will you give them what you promised? Or will you make up another boogeyman to control your citizens?
Here you go again with the lies.
Really? Then tell your men how they feel about working in minefields for days to no end. Oh right, you can't, because if they did tell you their true feelings, you'd kill them. You there, with the gun pointed at me. Do you feel fulfilled? Do you think that if you kill me and my friends, that you'll finally achieve your dreams? Is this really the only way that the American dream can come true?
What the hell are you waiting for, you useless fool? He's trying to manipulate you. Shoot him now.
I can't.
What?
The mud is right. What the hell are we doing? We've been serving you and your empire for God knows how long, and you've given us nothing substantial back. Just earlier you called us worthless peasants. Is that really who we want to serve?
I'm giving you an order to kill him now.
No.
Excuse me?
I lay down my arms.
Yeah, he's got a point. Why should we be loyal to this bozo? I'm laying my arms down too.
Count me in.
I'll lay down both my arms, if I have to.
No. You stop this immediately.
We no longer serve you, Stuart.
Very well then. Chungus, kill these traitors. I've had it up to here with your fucking tricks, and I won't let you turn my men against me. It's time for you to die.
No. I won't let you do that.
Go ahead and kill me, and I'll make sure Chungus takes your friends with me. Is that what you want? You have two options: either we all die, or you fulfill your destiny and merge with Lilith. What will it be? Death, or destiny?
Ray, don't do this. He'll kill us all either way.
Alright. I'll do what you want.
No.
Yes. Finally, things are going my way. Well then, hurry up. We don't have all day.
Ray, listen to me. It's a trap. He's gonna try to control you. Don't do this.
It's okay, Doge. I know what I must do.
The piercing radiant moon, the storming of Borju, all the life running shallow years in fright. Dreams are made winding through my heart.
Rain?
Doge, you and your friends must live.
What's going on? How is this happening?
You along with everyone else returned into LCL, but I cannot let them just die. I will rebuild the world anew, and give them a second chance.
But what about you?
You no longer need to worry about me anymore. I will be reborn anew. I am free. Please, give them a second chance as I have. Farewell, Doge.
No. Don't go.
Thank you. For everything.
Doge,
Don't. Please wake up.
Zeems. We're alive. Wait, are we alive? Are we dead?
Doesn't feel like it.
Did we win?
Quite plausibly.
I see. What about everyone else? Are they okay?
I don't know. I just wamka, same as you.
Zeems, where are you? Can you hear me?
Murphy?
Rusty, look.
Big brother.
Murphy, Rumsty, you're all okay.
I'm not dead! I'm not dead!
We were looking all over for the both of you, and now we're all together. Oh wait, I forgot to mention someone else. Where's Ray?
Ray? Jeez. She's gone.
What?
I'm sorry, Pen-Pen. I didn't want her to go either.
Heathens. All Heathens. Do you really think that you've bested me, the Almighty King Stuart?
It's over, Stuart. Just be glad that you're still alive.
No. This is not over. That which violated my soul. I'll have a new and more loyal army. One that won't be fooled by your fancy words. Well, speak of the devil. Maybe I won't need a new army. I'll just let Chungus finish you all off. Now, Chungus, kill them. I said, kill these fools. Are you even listening? Damn it, why won't this blasted thing work? No. Unhand me, you brute. Please, don't kill me. I can turn over a new leaf.
You murdered my people, put a control chip in me, and made me eat rats. And now after all that, now you wanna be my best friend? No. You don't deserve forgiveness. You only deserve to die.
No.
Normally I'd be grossed out, but considering who he was, I'll let this one slide.
By God, Big Chungus killed the king. This can only mean one thing. Big Chungus is our new leader. All hail King Chungus.
King, King, Chungus, King Chungus, King Chungus. King, King, Chungus, King Chungus, King Chungus.
No, I can't be your king. Why would you serve someone like me? I'm a monster. I've caused too much pain. I'm sorry for everything that I've done to you all. Words cannot express the deep regret I have inside. I don't deserve to be king, or anything. I just wish to be left alone.
Well, if Chungus won't be our king, who will rule us?
Maybe we don't need a new ruler. Maybe we can create our own system, one without kings. Where we the people are the rulers of our own destiny.
Are you saying that we should create our own social democracy?
If that's what you call it, then yeah.
That concept has never been tried before. But I guess it wouldn't hurt to try. I'd say from now on, this planet will be called the Social Democratic Republic of Rats.
Yeah, I'm down with that.
Sounds good. But what would our first policy be?
Well, let me think. Free healthcare for everyone. I do say, Brave Mutt, do you have free healthcare where you live?
Man, I wish.
Well, maybe one day, you can give your people free healthcare as well.
If only it were that easy.
Oh, we almost forgot, I believe this belongs to your mechanic friend.
My weapons. You know, maybe you rats aren't so bad after all. Come on, Rusty, this bag ain't gonna carry itself.
Come on everyone, let's start building our new democracy.
Guess this is where we part ways.
Yeah, guess so.
I want to thank you for everything you've done. Your father was a hero, we just couldn't see it then.
Thanks. That means a lot to me.
I'm sorry about what happened to Reddy. She would have loved to be here.
Yeah, she would have loved being here. Guess I better go. They're waiting for me.
Before you do, I have one more thing to say. Sorry for calling you a mutt.
Yeah, sorry for calling you plagues.
Don't.
Doge, are you coming or what?
Yeah, I was just about to leave.
Big brother, do you really have to go again?
Unfortunately, yes.
I just hope that you won't get into any danger again.
Don't worry, I'll be safe, especially with Doge by my side.
I can't thank you enough for what you've done for us. We would have never made it this far without you, and especially not without Ray. I'm gonna miss her.
We're all gonna miss her.
Bye-bye, big brother.
Bye for now, Rumsty.
If you need anything, give us a call.
We'll do, Murphy. We'll do.
Hey, I know what'll cheer you up. How's about finishing up on that anime you like?
Captain Falcon.
Zeems, I feel like I'm forgetting something. Oh shit, how could I have forgot? Hello, I'm Doge, and welcome to another edition of Doge News, where we bring you the latest scoop on movies, games, and world events. Let's start off with some breaking news. An Amazon factory in Edwardsville, Illinois collapsed during a deadly tornado storm that has ravaged across six states such as Kentucky and Tennessee. Six Amazon workers who were inside the fulfillment center during the storm were unfortunately killed as a result. It has been alleged that the Amazon workers weren't allowed to leave the building during the storm, which could lead to some criminal negligent charges. Amazon has been no stranger to controversy. Just earlier this year, it was reported that the working conditions were atrocious, with reports such as employees urinating in empty water bottles and defecating on bags, most likely as a result of getting penalized if they ever used the restroom. Also earlier in the year was the Amazon union vote in Alabama, which the union unfortunately lost the vote. And let's not forget Jeff Bezos, the founder and executive chairman of Amazon, who is also the richest man in the world with a net worth of $201.7 billion. He has enough money to end world hunger and improve people's material conditions, but chooses not to. OSHA has now started an investigation into the fatal Amazon warehouse collapse. Such a sad and ultimately avoidable tragedy. In other news, an anime YouTuber by the name of Totally Not Mark had 150 of his videos taken down by Toei Animation, the animation studio behind the Dragon Ball franchise, One Piece, Sailor Moon, and many more. The YouTuber addressed in a video that he would no longer support any Toei-related products until all his videos were reinstated. Only 20 of his 150 videos have been reinstated by Toei as of this video's production. Mark has since unlisted two of his videos in response to Toei, and has stopped his boycott due to mental health concerns. How very disappointing that the copyright system can be abused by corporations with fragile egos. One last bit of news for today. Political socialist Twitch streamer, Hassan Abi, was banned from Twitch for a third time, after using the word cracker on his stream. The word cracker is a supposed slur against Caucasian people, dating back centuries ago, that was used as a term against poor rural white people and immigrants. The term is now used by minorities to call out racist white people. Other Twitch streamers such as Vosh and Fawn have been banned for using the word. This is most likely an attempt by Twitch to circumvent hateful speech, after the hashtag, #TwitchDoBetter, was trending earlier this year. Although Hassan Abi argues that the term cracker isn't a slur because the word lacks historic and contemporary oppression, like words such as the N-word. Such a strange and weird decision by the Twitch admins. Well, that's all the time we have. Tune in next time for another edition of Doge News. See you soon.
So, now whammed?
I don't know. Guess I go back home. I can always lie to them and say I scattered his ashes. I'm going to my room. What's this?
Doge, if you're reading this, then that means we won, and that I have passed on in a new life. There's no need to search for me, I am happy where I am now. I do have one last gift for you. Please look at the desk. Please promise me that you'll take your father's urn and scatter his ashes at the end of the universe. No matter how hard or dangerous it gets out there, promise me that you'll never give up. I leave you with a poem. The years at the spring, and days at the morn. Mornings at seven, the hillsides dew pearled. The larks on the wing, the snails on the thorn. God's in his heaven, all's right with the world.
Okay, Ray. I promise.
Hey Doge, what are you reading?
A parting gift.
Your father's urn.
I've changed my mind, Zeems. I'm not going back. I want to travel through the end of the universe, and I want you all to be a part of it.
Go everyone!
Well, what's stopping you? You're still the captain after Elm.
Yeah. You're right. Well then, what the hell are we waiting for? Wheatley, set course for eastward. We're going on an adventure.
Here we go!
Siri, activate light speed.
Wow, that was some show.
Hey, it was okay, I guess.
So, any constructive criticisms?
Well, I felt that it went on for too long. I mean, that's almost 25 minutes of watching what's basically a meme show.
Yeah, and it took you 20 minutes to get to the actual news part. Maybe if you weren't so pretentious, you'd be a better writer.
Thank you for your input.
I did like the part where Rey started the third impact again. Though you do know that she's supposed to use the Spear of Longinus to merge with Lilith, right? You have seen Evangelion, have you?
No.
What? You've never seen the fucking show?
Well, at least it was slightly faithful to the source material. It's at least better than the Cowboy Bebop remake.
Somehow this seems worse.
You know, I wasn't asking for your opinion.
Well, you just did like a minute ago.
I went too far with this.
What? With the episode?
No, with this whole damn show. Now I gotta write 2 more seasons and a prequel movie out of this. Jesus Christ. And can somebody wake this jackass up? He's been asleep since the damn episode started.
Hey, don't blame him for you boring him to sleep.
You know, I'm getting really sick of your snarky remarks here. Jesus, you're worse than that German friend you got. What's her name again? Alaska or something?
You know damn good and well that's not her name.
Whatever. I'm getting me a coffee.
I better get a huge paycheck for being in this schlock.
Yes, I know, Ray. We discussed this before. Jesus Christ, why don't you just nag at my fucking ear, see if that helps?
Don't tempt me with a good time.
Now shut up!
Sup? What I miss?
Well, tune in next time for another exciting season of Doge News, starring me, Zeems, and all your rather favorite cartoon pals. How do I end this video?
Wait, the episode.